Hello, this is Aubrey and welcome back to my channel. And today, Maritime PowerPoint presentation, because we will be talking about the demo lesson. Okay, so considering that you finished the first step, the one that you had to check your microphone and your video, and then you have to answer two questions, after you were informed by Ingo that you passed the first step, you would now go to the demo lesson. Okay, so if you haven't checked that out, I made a video with the complete step-by-step requirements. Make sure to check that out. In a demo lesson, you would have two sessions. First is the daily news material, and then the next one is the free conversations. You don't have any material for this because it's just like chikahan, free conversation, okay? What is daily news? Daily news is just an article that you and your student would read, and your main tasks include reading the article, of course, and then correcting the pronunciation of your student, explaining new words. For example, the student encountered a new word within the article, so you would explain that, and then you would discuss the article later on. So this is a screenshot of the daily news articles found in Ingu. And so in your demo lesson, you would not know which article the employee or like the disguised student would choose. All articles have the common like mainframe or format. Magkakaiba lang sila, of course, laman, no content. So that is for the daily news. What is the free conversation? For the free conversation, you would have these main tasks. You would keep the conversation going. You would encourage the student to speak. And of course, bring out your inner chismosa. Now we go deeper into each one. So first, we will talk about your script. Okay, I would provide three scripts for this lesson. Three. What to say at the beginning, what to say in the middle, and what to say at the end. Okay, I'm generous. Before starting your lesson, you have to do these first. First, you have to check your audio and your video. And then, you would ask if they would like to have an introduction. So here, dahil mabait ako, I provided like two examples of how you could say this. For example, hello, before we start our lesson, can you hear me clearly? Mm-hmm. Also, is my video clear? So you could say that. If you noticed, I was like doing gestures because sometimes your students are, you know, beginners or intermediate. It would be easier for them to understand what you're saying if you have, you know, gestures. Okay, another way of saying this one is, hello, is my audio okay? Yeah? How about my video? So like that. Okay, and you have to make sure then that you don't speak too fast, okay? Because the main rule here in Ingo is that you would match the pace of your student. If your student is a slow speaker, like a beginner, you would also speak slowly. For example, your student said, yes, your video is okay, your audio is okay, like that. You would now proceed to the second one, which is the introduction. There are different ways to say this introduction. For example, my name is Bianca, so I will type my name in the chat box while I'm saying it. Okay? What's your name? Like that. Okay. Or for example, you can also say, hello, my name is Bianca. How about you? How do you want me to call you? You would now ask. Okay. For example, the student's name is Burn. For example. Okay, Burnson. It's nice to meet you. To check, would you like to do self-introductions before the lesson starts? Or you can also say, nice to meet you, Burnson. So, do you want to do self-introductions or do you want to skip it? Some students kasi prefer to skip the introduction. Wala silang pakialam sa'yo. Charot! But some students, they want to skip it, but some students want to practice introducing themselves. That's why they want to have self-introductions. But for the demo lesson alone, you would have introductions talaga. But since this is a simulation, you would have to still ask. For example, your student said, yeah, I would like to do self-introductions, please. You would say, okay, Burnson, do you want to go first? Or do you want me to go first? Or it really depends if your student likes to go first and hayaan sila. But if they want you to go first, you have to say, sure, no problem. Like, chicken, chicken. So for your introduction, it has to be short. Huwag telenovela because your time is limited. And in the first place, hindi ikaw dapat ang nasa spotlight. It has to be your student. Because your student is the one practicing English, not you. So your introduction has to be short. You don't need to use fancy words like highfalutin words. No, no, no. You don't need those. And also, your information must be relevant. And you shouldn't, you know, share too personal information. Your introduction could have the following. And if you like to add more, it's up to you. But for my introduction, I just say my name, my age. I am a student, so I say that I'm a student. And my hobbies. So how do I introduce myself? I would just say, hello, my name is Bianca, and I am a first year university student from the Philippines. And my major is international relations. And my hobbies are watching movies, reading books, and watching anime. My favorite movie is Frozen 2, and my favorite anime is Naruto. So remember, after saying your introduction, you would have to like inform your student in a way that your introduction is complete. Like, for example, you could say, that's my introduction, thank you for listening. And after that, your student would introduce himself. You would have at least one or two follow-up questions about the student's introduction. So for example, the student said they like watching movies. You would ask, ah, okay, so you said here, Burnson, that you like watching movies. May I ask, what is your favorite movie? Remember that your introduction shouldn't be too long, okay? It must be around 3 to 5 minutes only. Let's go back to daily news. After you introduced yourself, you would now go to the daily news. Daily news is the first demo session. Even though it is about daily news, you would ask your student to check, Burnson, you said here you would like to read daily news article, correct? Your student will say, yes, correct. Your main tasks in your daily news is you would read the article, correct the pronunciation, explain the new words, and discuss about the article. Now, remember what I said, that even though the articles differ with their content, they have the same format. Daily news has 4 to 5 exercises per article. So let's take this article for example. This is a screenshot of an article from Inggu. The title of the article is "This company wants to build a hotel in space." For the title, for the topic, for the article, it's completely random, so wala akong mabibigay dyan, but I would just present to you the format. So the daily news starts with the exercise 1. The tutor must first ask if the student would like to start with exercise 1 or skip it, because some students like to skip this one. Since we are in a simulation of the legit class, you would ask your student if they would like to read the exercise 1 vocabulary. So you would ask, okay, Burnson, so would you like to start with the vocabulary or would you like to skip it? If the student would like to start with the exercise 1, we would like to ask first if they would like to read by themselves or they would like to repeat after you. Because some students, again, remember that some students are beginners or intermediate. So sometimes they still need guidance. So how would that work? For example, you would first read the word, orbit, and then your student will follow. And then you would read the meaning. The path that is taken by an object moving around a planet, sun, etc. And then the student would repeat. To recap, these are the things that you should ask your student with the exercise 1. Remember? Would you like to start with exercise 1 or skip it? Would you like to read by yourself or repeat after me? Would you like to read all sentences or just one per word? Because if you notice, there is the drop down button, so orbit the word, meaning that there are more than one sample sentences for that word. Some students like to read all of the sentences, but some students like to read only one of them. Now let's go to the article. Exercise 2. For the article, this is just the question that you should ask. Would you like to read by yourself or repeat after me? Your students may choose to read by themselves, repeat after you, or read it alternately. For example, if they want to read by themselves, bala ka dyan, yo, ganun lang. Papakinggan mo lang if they make like errors with their pronunciation, or for example, they can't read a word. It would help them. If they want to read after you, you would first read the title. This company wants to build a hotel in space. This company would like space. Okay, after that, the first paragraph. Can't find any destinations on Earth for your next holiday? Lucky for you. So, you would first read the first article and then your student would read the article after you. Ganun. And how would this work? The third one. Alternate yung magbabasa. Meaning, you would first read the first paragraph and then your student would read the second. And then you would read the third. Your student will read the fourth. Ganun. Alternate. I did not know about this. Ang akala ko lang, they would either read it by themselves or repeat after you. Hindi ko alam na pwedeng alternate. And during my demo lesson, gulat ako, alternate, huh? Ano yun? And then let's go to the exercise 3. For the third exercise, it would be just questions about the article. And remember that the teacher's note is only visible for us tutors. Hindi siya visible for the students. Okay, Bernson, now let's go to exercise 3 questions. Okay, for the first question, when is the Voyager station expected to open? And then the student would answer. Now, exercise 4 and 5 are just, you know, discussions that would encourage students to share their thoughts about the article. So if you look here with the questions, what are your thoughts on Voyager station? Ganun. So you would encourage them to speak and to form complete sentences. And while they are speaking, it is encouraged that you type their sentences so that if in case you heard like an error, you could type the correct sentence, and after your student, you know, answered the question, you would point out the error. Just make sure that you won't use like highfalutin words while explaining. Here are some reminders. Demo lessons are just 15 minutes long, okay? Applicants will first be briefed in the Zoom meeting and would be given the link to the lesson room privately. Okay, so what does this mean? So, applicants, iipunin lahat yan sa Zoom. And then, the Inggu employee would privately message you. Your demo lesson is scheduled around 10:45, for example. And here is the lesson room link. And then, of course, make sure that you time your demo lesson, because your student will not inform you if your time is up. This happened to me. Nag-overtime ako ng 2 minutes because I forgot to time my demo lesson. Now, let's talk about the free conversation. The main tasks in the free conversation are keep the conversation going, encourage the student to speak, and bring out your inner chisposa. Okay, madali lang siya because para lang kayo nagchichikahan, para lang kayo nag-uusap. But sometimes it's very challenging if you don't know what to talk about. So, in a free conversation, your topics usually revolve around these, the hobby, the pandemic, the pets, movies, music. That's why it's really important for you to listen to the student's introduction. You would use their hobbies or things from their introduction to be the topic of your free conversation. You have to make sure that your student feels comfortable during your talk. You should avoid too personal questions, and you shouldn't argue with your student because, like I said, sometimes we have conflicting views. And this is not the right platform to argue about our conflicting views. This platform is about learning English, nothing more, nothing less. So even though you have conflicting views, for example, about religion or about politics, it's not the right place to talk about it or to argue about it. And also, you would encourage the student to answer incomplete sentences. Remember that the demo lessons are just 15 minutes long, and you will be given another link for your free conversation demo lesson. So it's not the same with your first link. Again, click the link only when it's your time already. And make sure to time your demo because your student will not inform you if your time is up. Now, how do we end this? Tama na. Ayoko na. You would give your feedback to the student at the last minute of the lesson. So since this is a demo lesson, sa 14th minute, pero in the actual class, sa 24th minute, ka magbibigay na feedback. And basically, you would include both the good and the, you know, errors, like points of improvement, ganun. And you would also commend the student for their skills. Because in Ingu, they believe that hindi mo sila dadaanan sa sindak, hindi mo sila dadaan sa ganun. You will not use force or intimidation. Instead, you would, you know, use the positive encouragement. Like, yes, kaya mo yan. It's hard, I understand, but you can do it. So it's, you know, encouraging words like that. Hindi mo sila sisindahin. This is my script, actually. And dahil mabait ako, I would share this script for you. But for example, your student's still speaking, sige, after they are done speaking, you would use this, wow, Bernson, that is really nice. I really enjoyed our conversation, Bernson. However, it is almost time already. I am really impressed with your intonation when reading the article. Just remember to practice pronouncing these words, the words that I typed in the chat box, okay? Don't worry, because I will include these in your lesson notes. Before we end, do you have any questions? None? Okay. Good job, Bernson, and have a good day. Bye! And that's basically it. That is how you ace your demo lesson. I've given you the what to say first part, the second part, and the last part. Napakabait ko talaga. But again, don't forget to put me as your referral. My tutor name is Bianca, and my tutor ID is M8753. Also, don't forget to use Crisp because we all now working at home, and sometimes may mga aso tayong epal. So it would be better if you use Crisp, the noise cancellation app. I will put the link below. Make sure to use my link, so that you would have 1 free month of the premium account. If you have questions, please comment them down below. Bye!